I was really excited to work with this experiment of a found footage film, which was going to happen in real time, about this particular, weather condition. I think, more and more we see the escalation of the forces of nature. Even though this isn't really based on anything specific, I just thought those three elements were going to make for a film that I hadn't seen before.
Yeah, and it was. I mean, even when we first got the script, it was just really cool to see something that was, an effects film that was really driven by a human story. You know, you're given a snapshot of this family's life and how this event changes it and the way that they kind of deal with each other from that moment on. That was really interesting because you can be left flat sometimes by things blowing up and cities being destroyed. But I think that the human story of Into the Storm really stands up.
Well, I think the conceit as well at the beginning of setting up a day in the life of these people that are filming themselves for posterity in a time capsule type thing, so that, and they're all talking about how their lives are going to be in 10 years time or 20 years time, whatever it is, and what 25, yeah. What they hope for themselves on the very same day when that is all put in jeopardy.
Yeah.
And the moment when these guys leave for school on that day, that the last word that you have with your son, which is we have a little bit of an argument, and then there's the potential that they may never see each other again, that it may never be resolved. And just because of a moment in time, and I think that is something that people hopefully will relate to. And as much as, like you say, everybody loves a disaster movie, but when there's something like that to connect you into the sort of heart of these people that are experiencing it, I think it makes it a very different experience.
The snapshot you get gives you a lot about the family early on, these people that are struggling with their own disasters, personal disasters, in losing their mother and just trying to survive the business of life. Are then asked to survive something completely different, and that's in the end what kind of brings them together.
I don't know if we had any professional advisors, but I have to say, I totally believed in the character of Alison. I think Sarah came to work with so much research done. I actually found myself sitting down with her, asking her what would happen in these, and what the TF5 meant, and she was a real authority. Actually, she totally, took on that role, and
I think so much so that she was sometimes she'd say, "Oh, I don't think this would happen like this," and explaining why the hook coming a certain way would mean something else. And
it's true.
She knew a lot about storms. Yeah, I think she made us all feel a bit insignificant with all that.
And she was fun in the pub as well. So I mean, God knows how she does it.
Great,
powerful in the pub. Yeah.
He was pretty open, wasn't he?
Yeah.
About whenever we came to him with character ideas or character development ideas, because there was so little time in the actual story that characters could reveal themselves. Because as soon as the storm kicks off, it's such a moment-to-moment existence for the characters that he was very open to all of that.
Yeah, hugely trusting in what you were going to bring to the characters and the ideas that we'd had, I think. If we came in with something that we thought would make it better or something that maybe didn't make as much sense as it should, he was always willing to assimilate our ideas. And
it's the great thing about working on film as well, is that you can play all of these things, and it doesn't necessarily have to make it into the film, but it somehow can. I think there was a moment with your rescue at the end where there was a knife that had sort of, it just wasn't in the script, and it gets passed between brother to brother. It's the knife that I take off of Trey that ends up saving Donnie, and it was just the tiniest detail that we all suddenly recognized, and Steve went with it, and it was just a nice little moment, because he gives his knife back to his son at the end, and it's symbolic.
Yeah, I can't believe
think the first day I arrived, there was a lot of have you seen the TARDIS yet? This is it's a tank. It can't be destroyed. You know, everyone was very proud of what the work they'd done in TARDIS. And the TARDIS is hugely impressive in the film, but in real life, a nightmare. I think it's safe to say.
I wasn't in that vehicle very often. I remember it being squeezed into the centre seat for a couple of days, and I wasn't impressed with the TARDIS. Give me my high school any day. They can take their TARDIS.
It looks very cool, but windows smashing and rain pouring in.
And it leaked.
It leaked a lot. Yeah, cool. In theory, fantastic.
It was something that, again, I really... was excited me about the script is that there was the potential for all of these characters to simply be observed in their extreme situations rather than setting scenes up to play to camera. You know, it gave you much more freedom within the scene to improvise and be, you know, be captured in the same way that the storm was being captured. I think Gary's probably the only character that never picks up a camera. If he's not seen, he's not in the scene. So. That was quite nice.
Yeah, yeah. I mean, the found footage thing is just so adds to the immediacy of the storm and everything that's happening. And I think also the moments between people, you know, it's just more being a kind of voyeur on those moments makes it all more interesting.
It became quite an interesting exercise of when the cameramen were holding the main cameras that you would always be asking, are you Trey, are you Donnie, are you Alice, who are you?
Because yeah.
Often, if you refer to the camera, the camera became one of the characters that you would talk to. So
yeah.
That was interesting. And then there was a God camera as well, which was the sort of big, wide observer of everything, which slowly made its way in.
Yeah, I think what's great about the film is that the found footage thing so plays a part in it, and also once it begins, it doesn't hamper the action at all.
Yeah,
you know, it's you know. It doesn't hold us back at all in telling the story.